The Constitution is definitely a very important book because it governs our day-to-day lives. If you take out a constitution, the country cannot run. But is every single thing written in the Constitution to be treated as a doctrine? I don't think so. You might have your personal views, but I disagree because it's not possible that rules written in the past govern our present and shape our future. That's not possible because anything written in the Constitution, as societies evolve, as human beings evolve, the rules that govern us should also evolve. And this is something I strongly believe in. I'll just give you an example of one of my biggest issues with the Constitution in its current state. Schedule 10, paragraph 2, clause B of the Constitution. How many of you have heard of the Anti-Defection Law? These days it's a very popular word going around as well. The Anti-Defection Law was instituted in 1985 to make sure that politicians, after they get elected from a particular party, don't skip parties and, you know, do something undemocratic that might weaken the strength of government. And I welcome that. That was a very important reform. Clause B of the same paragraph, paragraph 2 of Schedule 10, says that if an individual member of the parliament votes against party lines, against the way a party wants them to vote on a particular bill or law, they can be disqualified if they do that as well. I don't agree with that for two reasons. If a party in power, if a government in power knows that no matter what bill they introduce, it will get passed because the members of their party are supposed to vote a particular way, where is the incentive for our lawmakers to make better laws? Where is the incentive for them to introspect about the tiniest of details to make sure we get it perfect? There isn't. And the second reason why I disagree with this clause is because what is the point of being the greatest democracy in the world and being the largest democracy if democracy ends after a particular member is elected into the government? Because, let me tell you, say tomorrow a bill is introduced about river linking or something about the way water bodies are governed. And as a representative of Karnataka, I think that that new law has the potential to disadvantage some of my people. I should have the right to go to parliament, raise that issue and say, dear elected representatives, this particular law, this particular bill causes harm to my people because of A, B, C reasons, and I urge you to vote against it. Similarly, a particular person who has introduced that bill, they will come and they will speak for it. And if you're able to convince and represent the issues of your people in parliament and a majority of the elected members vote the way you want to vote, then you're democratically doing your duty as a representative. Now I think this is lost because of that particular second clause in the Anti-Defection Law. Now this is just a small thing, you may not even agree with me. But imagine if each one of us had some wrong that we want to correct, some small clause that we want to change, something that we want to raise questions about, maybe even a small idea, then there will be some change. So the entire burden, the responsibility of setting laws right and making sure our respected constitution, is created in a way that every day it's becoming, optimal and better suited to govern our people, that responsibility lies on us, the future generation, the next generation that's coming.